The United States fundamentally rejects the announcement today from the prosecutor of the International Criminal Court that he is applying for arrest warrants for senior Israeli officials together with warrants for Hamas terrorists.
So are you okay then with the application for arrest warrants against Hamas?
We do not believe that they have jurisdiction over either of the parties of this
conflict. So you don't think that Hamas. You don't think that Hamas should be prosecuted?
We absolutely believe that Hamas should be held accountable. That could
held
be
accountable.
Hold on. Let me finish. That could be either through the prosecution of the war effort by Israel. It could be
in other words, hold on. Being killed.
It could be by being killed. It could be by being brought to justice in an Israeli court. We do not believe the ICC has jurisdiction over either of the parties in this case.
So let's just focus on jurisdiction for a second. Who does have jurisdiction here?
So the government of Israel has jurisdiction.
Over Gaza, which is not entirely occupied.
They have jurisdiction into looking at the actions by their
so
military personnel.
So the Palestinians,
personnel.
If they have a complaint, they have to bring it to Israeli courts.
We have jurisdiction. And we
have
with the use of our equipment.
I'm sorry. How do you have jurisdiction?
With the use of our military equipment
that we have
provided.
How do you have jurisdiction?
If you look at the Leahy Law, if you look at...
That's not jurisdiction in a criminal process. That's
not in a criminal process, but it has to do with... The determinations that we make and the policies that flow
from it.
Yeah,
but that's not jurisdiction.
So, but Matt, long term, you were right that we want
to
see.
You used to work for DOJ, Matt. Come on. There's no U.S. does not have jurisdiction.
There are different.